In 1922, Puccini wrote, Turandot languishes. I haven't got the second act as I want it yet, and I don't feel myself capable of composing music anymore. If I had a charming, light, sentimental subject with a touch of burlesque in it, I think I could still do some good, but with a really serious subject like Turandot, no. Perhaps Turandot will end by going to the wall. So I must look for something else with an eye to London. On the subject of which, I see that for many years I have reigned over Covent Garden, and I'm glad of it. But now that I'm an old man, I think I might have received some form of recognition from your great country. The father, no less than the son, the present King George V, loved and loves my music. And I know that whether at the opera or at court, they wanted and they want songs from Boheme and Butterfly and La Tosca. And never once have they thought of that author who has reigned for so many years in their home on the throne of the music of the theatre. Now, that's the end of my outburst, which is only a passing thought that has just come to me and has died as quickly as it was born. For if there is one man in the world who does not care for knick-knacks to be put on his evening dress, I am that man. And the real meaning of my outburst is that I love that country, England, and want to go on reigning there. And since 1894, the first performance of Manon. The more I think of it, the more I believe my Turandot will be particularly suited to the British public.
Thank you. la tua fredda sta.